Hey guys, this is Monica at Academic Phoenix Plus, and today I wanted to go over Maya Basics UV Mapping. This is an introduction to how to use the tools provided by Maya. You can use these to UV map just about everything. So again, this is more for beginners, and let's go ahead and get started. So this is a scene. Right now we have a plane, a cube, a cylinder, and a sphere. Now you can download this scene at academicphoenixplus.com, or you can always just create it yourself because I just used the basic polygon models over here at the top. But in case you don't want to go through all the effort, here you go. I'm all about making it easy for you guys so you can learn as much as you can. So again, if you want to download this, you can find this at academicphoenixplus.com and you can download it for free. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about the theory of UV mapping. So let's say that you have a 3D model that looks like this and you want to texture it in a unique way. So what you do is very similar to a paper doll. You spread it out like so in Photoshop, and then you will draw on it. Once you have the shape and the details that you want on the texture, then you reapply it to the 3D model. So that would be something like this. If you wanted to do more complicated models, let's say these cute little cats right here, you would have the printout. So you would lay it out like this. As you can see, it's not a perfect square, but because of its complicated shape, you're going to have interesting looking UVs, a little bit more organic, and you draw out your details that you want. And then you go back to your 3D model and you apply it. So let's take a look at some examples of UV maps. Here's an example of a character that has been laid out. As you can see, you have numbers, you have colors, and the grid is laid out in a square. A character is very complicated, so you can see that there's a lot of pieces to that character. Here's one where it's just the head, so the head can have its own UV space. Here's the chest area, it seems, and this is probably the tongue. The nice thing about this is that you just go ahead and texture it, and then whoa. This is fancy. It's a nice little gift that I got, but basically just lays it out and then you put the textures on top of it. Using that information, you'll be able to actually put texture on it and the character will look like this. Very similar to a paper doll. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at Maya and all of its tools that it has. So as we know about UV mapping is that we are going to take an object that is 3D and somehow lay it flat so we can export the UVs into a image manipulation software such as Photoshop. So up at the top over here, we have this thing called a UV editor. So let's go to UV editor. And right off the bat, you can see that we have a UV editor window plus our UV toolkit. Now, I could leave this open, but up here at the top right, Maya already provides us a very fancy workspace called UV editing. So let's go ahead and choose that. This makes it very convenient because all my UV toolkits are right here. My UV editor is right here. And then I've got my items here as well. Okay, as you notice, when I select my objects, each of them already have some sort of UV map. That's because it is a polygon. Now, just to show you, there are other surfaces that you can use, such as NURBS. So here's a NURB sphere, and you'll see that it really doesn't have any UV maps, not like this. And the reason why is because this is not really polygons, this is actually curves. So if I right click on this, you have isoparms, hull, and a bunch of other things. Versus here, you have, if I right click on it, I have edges, vertex, and faces. So it's just a little bit different. So moving on, so right off the bat, you can see that we have a plane. And this plane has a UV map. Notice that it goes from the 0 to 1 and 0 to 1. This is the X, this is the Y. The 0 to 1 space is where you want to lay out all of your UVs at the end. But notice that if I scroll out, you're going to notice that there's this huge UV space. So you have all this space, but eventually you are going to collapse it all the way to this space, 0 to 1. All right, so let me show you a little bit about this window up here. So the UV editor, this is the, if you just hover, you'll see that it's on wireframe. If you click on this one, it's going to show you what's called shaded. And shaded means that if there's any, it will show you if there's any overlap or if they're reversed. So what does that mean? Well, let me show you. Let's say I'm going to right click, grab my UVs. I'm going to grab these. It's like vertices basically, and I'm just going to overlap them. Notice that it turns purple. Well, this is purple. Kind of like a mix between purple and red. That just means that the UVs are not only overlapped, but they're also reversed. So if I move this up, you'll see that the UVs are actually reversed here. So that means that anything red, you want to be able to flip or somehow make sure that it turns blue. Blue means that this is correct. Red means that the UVs are facing the wrong way. This type of color means that it's overlapping. I'm going to undo that. So very similar to vertices, I could right click and you can select vertices if you want to. So that's cool thing about UVs is that you're not limited to just selecting vertices. UVs, you can also select vertices and faces. So this little guy right here is showing you that anything white means that there is no stretching and no collapsing. So when we do a little bit more complicated items, it's going to demonstrate to you. And again, if I hover, it'll tell you that it's going to show you any type of distortion. That means that if there's any type of, if it's stretching too much, it's going to start turning red. Or if it's compressed, it's going to start turning blue. So this is a way to visually see if something has some sort of distortion. This is our border. This is really important because we get to see the border of not only our UV shells, but also on the model. So for example, if we take a look at this one, you can see where the edges are. See the T? This is where it is. Moving on, if I had a texture, I can turn it on and off here. And this one is very handy. This is our grid. We used to have to find a texture and assign a grid, and now we don't have to, it actually comes with it. Now this is important because it tells us that the UVs are facing the right way, and if there's any type of distortion. So if the texture is a square and the UVs on the model is a square as well, that means that the texture is not going to stretch. However, let's say model is like this. You see all that stretching? That means that if I put a texture on here, it's going to stretch and it actually won't look good. So I would have to UV map this to make sure that it is nice and straight. So I will demonstrate that right now. The first thing we need to look at is up here at the top. Under UV, I'm going to demonstrate to you three UV mapping tools. One's called cylinder, one's called planar, and one's called spherical. As you can imagine, these are shapes. So if we have a plane here, which one do you think is going to be? Right, it's probably going to be planar. So let's just go to default. The object is plane, the projection is plane, and therefore everything looks good. Now notice the difference between before and after. Before, the UVs were really crushed. And now with planar mapping, it's now looking really good. I can move this left and right, by the way. So what does that mean? It means that if I put assign a texture to it, it's not going to stretch. It's going to look good. If I flip it over, you're also going to notice that if I go like this, notice that the UVs are backwards. So you got to keep that in mind when you use a plane, because that means that if you put text on this plane, so for example, let's say that this is a wall, it's got graffiti on it, the graffiti is going to be backwards on the other side. If you want to turn this off, you can. Think. And now you can see the UVs. So this is a pretty simple one. Now let's pretend though that my object is actually rotated like this. So I'm going to go to my attributes, change to -90. Let's say it's like this. And I'm going to, change the geometry just a little bit, maybe squish it a little bit more like so, maybe make it really long, something like that. I'm going to activate the map and you're going to notice that my UVs are stretched. So that means that I have to UV map. So I'm going to go ahead and go to UV planar map and a bunch of things happened. One, suddenly our grid is gone and now it's stretched. Right? This is not good because the square is supposed to show up and instead we have these really stretched rectangles. That means that everything is crushed into this one pixel. Over here to the right, if I turn this off, you're going to notice that there's this line. So what that tells me is that my UV map isn't really working when it comes to planar. So what can I do? Well, you really just need to go is to UVs, planar, and then go to the options. Under options, you're going to notice a couple of things. By the way, I probably should have shown this earlier. This is the default. You need to make sure that you turn on keep image with height ratio. Otherwise, it's going to project it into a square. I don't know why it's like this. I don't know why the default isn't this, but you have to turn it on and just make sure you keep it on. So what we were doing was actually using a Y. Now, if we want to do an X, and you can see that this is a Y going up and down. X is going left and right. We can choose X, make sure this is on, and then apply. And now we're getting that exactly what we need, which is a grid that looks exactly like our texture. And if I want to move this up, you notice that the text is perfect. So that's exactly what I need. Okay. Cool. Let's see what else I want to show you about planar mapping. And of course, if your UVs are like this, go ahead and change this to 90 degrees. and I try to keep the default and apply, you're going to get the same issue. Right? So that means that the plane's facing this direction, which is over here, a Z. Select Z, apply, and now the UVs are good. Awesome. Now what happens if it's crooked? Let's say it's something like crazy like this. What do we do? If I choose Z, doesn't really look that good. Notice how much it's warping the UVs. It's not going to look good. I can try Y. Y is all wonky. Good luck in texturing that. None of these are really working. So what can I do? Well, there's a fancy one called camera. And camera means that I have to look at the model the way I want it to UV map it. So something like this. And then I click apply. Whoops. Let me go to object mode. Apply. And now I have a projection based on the camera that I'm looking up for. So if I need to fix things, I can apply. And maybe I can get a better angle like this. Make sure you're in object mode. Apply. And then there you go. You now have a UV map based on the camera. This is really convenient if your faces are facing in an interesting or different way. All right, that was the first part of this tutorial for basics in UV mapping. The next part, we're going to talk about more UV mapping tools and how you can use them on other objects. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate your support and taking the time. The next episode, we're going to talk more about UV mapping. If you feel like this is helpful and you'd like to see more, please like, share, and subscribe. You can also download this file at academicphoenixplus.com. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.